silence. The power that happens between my next thought, my last thought, and my next thought. Silence is a way of communicating beyond the bounds of who we are and what we, and where we stand today. I'm going to be a little bit more in touch with these moments like this when you're just listening. Just listening. There's so much value in that space. I'm going to learn how to explore that more this summer. Ashe?
Ashe. When we travel, or when we go anywhere, it is always with an intern. You're never leaving a room, a classroom, a space without first your instructor giving you approval and you traveling with an intern. Because as I said, both spaces, particularly the library, is open to the public. We want to keep you safe. And so we have this protocol in effect. But part of you is accepting the responsibility to hear and follow the rules. Ashe?
Ashe.
As long as we know, and there's an intern with you traveling wherever you need to go, back from water to the office, that is where you are to be. No excuses. Excellence without excuse. Because your instructor will know your need. Okay? So, utmost important. When you're in the theater, you either walking into the theater, having a seat, no feet on the chairs. Ashe?
Ashe.
Because Ms. Jewel, up on the stage.
Ms. Jewel, what does this all transfer to? Because maybe because I think we're so close to home here. All the information that Ms. Jewel is giving, what does this transfer to, Ms. Jewel? When does this really become important?
It's important how you conduct yourself in the different venues during the performance. If you practice now, it will be all of that innate. And then you'll be mindful that those watching you will know that you have an understanding that you are respected. Valuing the space. And then basically how you represent yourself. Ashe?
Ashe.
And then all of this is with safety in mind. That you don't get hurt, someone doesn't hurt you. So as we enter on stage and we get used to a place, we don't then jump off the stage because we think it's fun. You understand? We go up the stairs, we go down the stairs. When you're in the side stage area where no one is ever leaning up against the ropes, anything like that. The side instruments, never. No hands, no people touching the rail, none of that. None of it. No matter how long you've been here.
One thing I would like to interject, and I did see, Ms. Jewel, during the dance portion that you guys had on stage, interns, I saw a lot of clumping and crowding. Like in the wings area, we gotta keep people out of the wings because with everybody standing over, it's really hard to see what's going on. You know, so you guys really have to take charge and say, okay, you know, keeping everyone organized because you know the students are new; they don't know necessarily how you know to be structured in the class. Like everything can't isn't gonna be like in a circle. I peeked in on the script. But if you guys want a circle, or maybe in the production design class, I don't know if you did a circle set, but that's a little easier to keep track of everybody. Mm-hmm. It's just hard when you guys are, what was your answer?
Oh, we did clubs and
group not on the floor.
The
right. So all of that, but in the dance, everybody was kind of crowded behind, and that just makes us nervous. So you guys really, that's what Ms. Jewel talking about, that safety, because anything can happen. We can't see. So be mindful of that. And then of course, like she said, on the railing,